Is lemon juice really strong enough to revive a dead battery? Or is that just a myth? Well, today, we're going to find out the old-fashioned way. I've got a dead battery here. Won't hold a charge. Won't light a bulb. Multimeter barely twitches. Most folks would toss it out. But before we give up on it, let's try something a little different. Back in the day, we didn't run out and buy new tools every time something quit working. We fixed what we had. And sometimes the simplest materials, like a lemon and some salt, can surprise you. We'll drain the old acid, clean the plates, mix up a little lemon electrolyte, and give this battery a second chance. I'm not saying it'll work like brand new, but if we can bring it back to life enough to power a light again, that's a win in my book. Let's roll up our sleeves and get started. Now let's open this battery up and clear out the old acid. Grab a flathead screwdriver and gently pry off the top caps. Don't rush it. These old lids can be stubborn, but they'll come loose. Next, I've got a big plastic tray ready, and I'm laying a piece of cloth over it. The cloth works like a simple filter. It'll catch dirt and sediment, so we don't pour junk everywhere. Carefully tip the battery over and drain the old acid through that cloth. Take your time. You don't want splashes. We're letting everything flow out nice and slow, and you can already see the debris staying on the fabric. This step is all about giving those plates inside a fresh start. If we're going to wake this battery up again first, we have to get rid of what's been holding it back. Now that the old acid is drained, we're going to give this battery a good rinse. Fill it with clean water, not all the way to the top, just enough to cover the cells. Put your thumb over the holes and gently rock the battery back and forth. We're not shaking paint here, just loosening leftover acid and dirt inside. Once it's mixed around, pour the water out the same way we drained the acid. You'll probably see cloudy liquid that's residue coming out, and that means it's working. To be thorough, we'll do this one more time. Rinse, swirl, and drain again. This helps neutralize what's left and preps the plates for our lemon solution. A clean start is the best start, especially with old batteries. All right, time to mix our battery revival juice. Grab a cup and squeeze in fresh lemon juice. The natural acid helps break down sulfate buildup inside the plates. Now add a spoonful of regular table salt. This boosts conductivity, giving our solution a little extra kick. Pour in some clean water and give it a good stir until the salt dissolves. Nothing fancy, just simple ingredients doing real work. This homemade mix is going to help loosen the stubborn deposits inside the battery so it can hold a charge again. Nature lending a hand in the workshop. You've gotta love it. Now let's put that lemon solution to work. Carefully pour the mixture into the battery cells, filling each one just enough to cover the plates inside. Now we wait about 15 minutes. During this time, the lemon acid and salt are breaking down the old sulfate buildup that's been suffocating the battery. All right, time to flush things out. After our lemon solution has done its work carefully, pour it out of the battery just like before, slow and steady. You'll probably notice the liquid looks cloudy or dark. That's the old buildup we just loosened up, and that's a good sign. Now fill the battery with clean water. Not all the way to the top, just enough to swish around inside. Put your thumb or a cloth over the holes and gently rock the battery back and forth. We're rinsing, not shaking paint, so easy does it. Pour that water out again and repeat the process a second time. Tell me what part of the world are you tuning in from today. Type your hometown in the comments. Two rinses helps make sure we've cleared out as much residue as possible, giving the fresh electrolyte a clean surface to do its job later on. This part may seem simple, but cleaning thoroughly now can make the difference between a weak revival and a battery that feels brand new again. Now that our battery's clean inside, it's time to refill it. Remember that filtered acid we saved earlier? Go ahead and pour it back into the battery. It still has useful electrolyte, and reusing it helps restore the chemical balance. Next step, we top it off with fresh sulfuric acid, 33.5%. Pour slowly and carefully until each cell reaches the proper level. Don't rush here. You want each chamber filled evenly. Now, grab your silicone sealant. Run a clean, steady bead along the seam where the cap meets the case. This step is important. It keeps fumes and dirt and moisture out and helps the battery hold pressure the way it should. Use a finger or a flat tool to smooth the silicone for a clean, airtight finish. And wipe off any excess while it's still soft. Once sealed, give it a minute to skin over. Nice and tight, just like tightening a gasket on an old carburetor. We want this battery ready to work hard again. Now that the battery's sealed, it's time to wake it up. We're going to jump charge it, just like giving a weak car battery a boost. Take a good fully charged battery and your alligator clip leads. Red to the positive terminal on the old battery, black to the negative. Then connect the other ends to the new battery, positive to positive, negative to negative. Let it sit like this for about 30 minutes. We're not trying to force power and just giving the old plates a gentle kickstart so they remember how to hold charge again. After half an hour, disconnect the clips. Always remove the negative first for safety. Grab your multimeter if the needle moves now. That means we're on the right track. But we're not finished. Hook the old battery up to a regular charger and let it charge slowly for about 2 to 3 hours. Slow charging is key. It restores capacity without overheating the plates. When that's done, we're finally ready to test it under load. All right, moment of truth. We've jump charged it, slow charged it now. Let's see if this old battery really woke up. First, unplug the charger and grab a simple test light or a 12-volt bulb. Clip it to the battery terminals and there we go. The bulb lights right up. That means this battery is officially holding power again. Not bad for something most folks would have thrown away. But before we call it done, let's clean the terminals so we get a solid connection every time. Take a little piece of fine sandpaper. Give both posts a quick polish to remove oxidation and grime. Then spray a light mist of WD-40 and wipe clean with a cloth. That'll help keep rust away and ensure the current flows smoothly. Battery revived contacts clean, ready to work just like new. Now this next part is just a fun bonus experiment. The kind of little trick a lot of old school tinkerers enjoy. We're going to use this revived battery to repair a broken light bulb filament, using nothing more than a piece of graphite from a battery and a couple of alligator clips. Thank you. Sometimes the older methods still have a little magic left in them. And there we have it, my friends. A completely dead battery brought back to life with nothing more than a little time, a little care, and yes, even lemon juice. We flushed out the old acid, cleaned the plates, ran a natural desulfation soak, added fresh electrolyte, boosted it, charged it, and tested it under load. And the result, a battery most folks would have thrown in the trash, is now working again, powering tools, lighting bulbs, ready for another chapter. Now look, I'm not saying this trick will revive every old battery. Some are simply gone for good. Plates too damaged, sulfation too deep. But when you do get one back, there's a special kind of satisfaction in that, isn't there? Feels like the old days, when we fixed things, not tossed them. When a man took pride in using his hands, his tools, and a little patience to make something run again. And that bonus repair with the graphite rod. Just a fun reminder that simple skills still matter. Sometimes the simplest tools in the shed can surprise you. If you enjoyed this project, if it brought back memories, inspired you to save something instead of replace it, do me a favor. Drop a comment below. Maybe just type lemon power so I know you watch to the end. Hit that like button. It really helps the channel grow. And if you're new here, consider subscribing. We've got more old school repair tricks, clever shop ideas, and hands-on DIY coming your way. Thanks for spending a little time here today. Take care, enjoy your tools, and always keep that maker spirit alive. I'll see you in the next one.